Hey, what's up, guys? So I got this PS2 right here, and I was gonna do a video about it because I found it for $12 at a Goodwill, which was a really good price. It came with a memory card, controller, and this badass internet port thing right here, which lets your PS2 hook up to the internet, which is actually kind of cool that I got that thing with it for free. But the problem is, it really doesn't like reading discs all that much. I worked a little bit for it at the beginning, but now it doesn't anymore. So this video is going to be me attempting to fix this with the disc read error. Hopefully it fares better than the last PlayStation 2, which I ended up destroying with a frozen burrito. If you want to take a look, there you go. Okay, so let's get started. You're going to need a couple of things to open this thing up and try and fix it. My AC is kicking on, that may produce some noise, I apologize. Oh well, anyways. So first we're going to need a flathead screwdriver. This thing will focus on my hand, I think it will. There it goes. So basically, this is to take off the tabs that are hiding the screws on the bottom. We're gonna need a regular Phillips head to take out those screws. We're gonna need a much smaller Phillips head. This is to take out the really small screws on the inside. And a pen or a marker to mark a few things inside so you know which way they came up and which way they need to go back in. Now, of course, I'm following a tutorial I saw online, so no actual idea if this will work. I've never done this. So, first off, we need to take off this adapter because it is big and it's in the way. This is another good use for the flathead. And as you can see, this thing is very, very dusty. So now we're gonna flip it down this way and start taking off the tabs. Here, these little leg tabs you can probably just pull up with your fingers. Alright, which reveal the screws inside. If you can't use your fingers, that's what the flathead is for as well. Now these little ones here around on the side are going to be a little harder to do, so, and of course these right here, so another reason for the flathead. We have two more to take off. Let me zoom in actually and show you how that looks like close up. These are the tabs right here. As you can see, I already took a lot of them off. Now the guide I'm looking at says there should be 10 of these, but I only found 8. So either I'm a complete dumbass or this PS2 is different. Next part comes the unscrewing. The screw in the middle here was pretty long compared to the other ones, so be careful with those. Just don't lose them all, keep them all nearby. That's advice I give for myself because I tend to lose stuff all the time. Alright, so now I got all my little parts in one pile. I've got all the screws taken out, I think. Now it's time to flip it over and try to take it apart. One thing I want to show you, this one has not been taken apart ever, I believe. Because this thing right here, I don't know if you can read that, let's try to get it in closer. Yeah, it's basically the old seal of good stuff that you're not supposed to take off. But you know, this thing's super old, there's no servicing it anymore, I mean, nobody would ever service it, so I'm gonna take it apart. So once you've properly cut up the little sticker, now you can probably just lift it off like this. And there you go. Top plate has been lifted off. Do be careful, the power buttons are attached right here, as I did not see. So you do want to be careful with that. Now on to the little screwdriver. Let's see if we can do this without completely messing it up. So, I actually had to get a really small flathead because I don't have a small enough Phillips head, but turns out it's working so far. Alright. Next, of course, take off this part right here. Which I believe we can do by just lifting up. Now, what we have to do is we have to actually plug the system in and open up the disk drive. At this point, we're going to shut this system off. Now that, you know, everything is open out there and you know exactly how it looks, what we need to do is try to adjust this white disc right here. Try to move it a little bit and see if that'll fix it. Basically, that's what they say. Now, I'm not sure this will work, of course, and we will need to test it. So now it says basically turn this little thing just slightly to one direction to see if it will work. Let's see, I've turned it two little things over. Let's see if that fixes anything. So now we have both power and the video plugged in. I'm gonna put the disc back into the disc drive. Put the power on. Let's close the disc and let's see what happens. Okay, so I've tinkered a little bit more with the insides, just mostly that one wheel thing, and I've also sprayed it a little bit with the spray duster thing, a bit of an insides, and now it seems to be working, kind of. It still goes through the whole loading disk screen, but it seems to be starting up a little quicker, just a little quicker, and I've put in four different disks, three games and one DVD to test it with. And it seems to be working. Let's restart it. And let's see, let's just see if it'll work this time on camera for me. Of course, I make no promises, but I hope it does. Otherwise, you know, I'd look like an idiot on video, which, I mean, I've done a lot of times before. I'm just gonna hit browse. And let's see how long it takes us to actually, for it to actually pop up. I'm sorry about the whole, you know, lines across the screen, but I can't really do anything about that. There we go. That was actually pretty quick. Nice. And a lot of the other games on the DVD are actually also that quick. I mean, as compared to how it was doing it before, I would call this a minor success, you know, as in, it's still not perfect, but I think it actually works now, which is really good. It feels really good to say. All right, so now we're gonna shove the whole thing back together. Thanks for watching, guys, and I will see you next week.